Alright, now let us discuss what is tax. First of all, you tell me taxes are obligatory in nature or optional in nature?
Obligatory.
Obligatory, but people are taking it as optional, isn't it? People are supposed to pay taxes, but they are not paying taxes. So what government can do? Government can make little stringent law, little strict law, so that people should pay the taxes on time, isn't it? So what are the taxes and why the hell we are paying taxes? This kind of question usually comes to your mind. Why one country should have tax system? Why are we studying tax system? What will happen without taxation? So for that, you need to go into the history of the taxation or how this taxation system has evolved over the period of time. Earlier we had, you know, something called kingdoms, isn't it?
Yes.
One particular region will be ruled by one particular king, and that king will have some set of rules and regulation for his own kingdom. Alright, now in those area, in those time, these kings used to provide us only one form of services, and that was the safety and security. Safety and
security.
If my neighbor nation attacks on me, you people do it on that game, no, COC game?
Yes.
What you do, you attack on neighbor nations, isn't it? Yeah, so same thing they were doing, because they were not having Android phone that time, they were doing it in reality. Yeah, kings were literally, they were attacking on each other nation just for fun sometime, just for, you know, some loot that they need to bring some nation, the wealth that that their neighbor nations has accumulated. They will go there, they will attack, they will defeat them, and they'll bring their wealth to their own nations, isn't it? Yeah, so this is what they were doing. So what is the responsibility of your ruler, your king? Your king should defend that particular attack. Okay, they should provide you strong military, and this is what king were providing. Instead, because they were giving this particular services of safety and security or defense in nowadays that we call, okay, that king used to charge some amount of taxes. Now those taxes were charged without having any basis. There were no act, no rule, whatever comes to their mind. Okay, 60% this time, okay, 70% this time, some ruler is to charge 100% this time. All right no, because of no legislation, no administrative system, there was an exploitation of people, and to make it in a sophisticated manner, they had put this particular as an act. There are various taxes that they used to levy. Earlier there was a barter system and all, I don't want to go into all those things, but there is a history of taxation, you should Google out and you should read. We are having amazing history of taxation system in India. Sir, why government is charging taxes? So when you go to church gate, there is an income tax building just on your left side. You go inside that, and first of all, there are two things that you can do in income tax as of now. Good canteen, so you can go and have food sometime there. Alright, good reasonable food we get in income tax. And secondly, on entrance only they had put one board, one big board. Go and check that particular board. In that board they had written, taxes are levied just like, you know, if they had compared tax system and government system as compared to the rain system. Okay, how the sun absorb rain, you know, some absorb water from land, from earth. Why? Because it can give it back in multiple fold in form of rain. So sun is absorbing rain, like, or water from India, or like world anywhere, like whole earth. And because it, like, in after few months it will give it in a multiple fold, and that too in pure form. You understand? So which can be useful. So this is the same system that they are following here. So why government is taking taxes? So government is absorbing money from you, so that government has very good intention of giving it to back you in multiple fold. You understand? Without that, we cannot have civilized society. Without taxation, we cannot have civilized society. We all want better education, isn't it? Yeah, we want better education, we want better healthcare, we want better road, we want better highway, we want better airport, we want better ports, we want everything better, but we are not ready to pay higher amount of taxes. This is the sad part, you know. You expect high level of demand. You are demanding too much from government, that government should do this, government should that, government has to do this, government is not repairing our road, government is not taking care of dam, government is not taking care of now flood situations in some states. Yeah, so how can government take care of this without having money in their hand, without having resources in their hand? So taxes will help them to put this particular resources. Now in rural areas also, in that time, kingdoms time also, when this particular defense, like you have to develop your troop, you know, your army, when soldiers are ready and nobody is attacking on you, you don't have intention to attack on anybody else, so these troops used to construct roads. Okay, this troop started constructing dam. This troop, the soldiers, they started constructing airport kind of thing. So these soldiers were always busy with some kind of activity that was given by ruler, and that's why this particular system has become as a governing body. Kingdom has become now governing body, government. Earlier king used to be the, like, you know, in like family members only will become king. Now we are having option in democracy, at least in India we are having option to choose our king. Choose our own ruling body, and that is a government. So government is not outside us, government is within us. Okay, some of you and me are government, isn't it? So we are the government. It's not that there is a government and government is working for us. No. We are the government. We appoint regulating body, and because that regulating body is working for us, what is your and my obligation? To pay taxes, because you are using their benefits. Sir, what type of benefit? Who had given you railway? Who is providing you police and all, law and order in the country? Government. Who is providing you defense? Why Pakistan and China is not attacking on you? Because we are having very strong defense. Isn't it? We are having highways, we are having road, we are having tunnels, we are having bridges, we are having all this system. Who is providing all this system? Government. What is the cost that you are paying to government to get these facilities? Taxes. Sir, but we don't pay taxes. You had paid taxes from your birth. You did not realize it because you have paid it indirectly. You buy any commodity in the market, even if you buy, for today's lecture, you must have purchased notebook and pen or stencil, some stationery. You check it MRP, in MRP it is written inclusive of. That means some form of taxes you had paid today as well. Okay, you are calling your friends, you are calling anybody in your house, that call itself has one form of taxes. You are eating food outside home. The moment you eat something outside home, you are putting some amount of taxes. So, but those taxes you haven't went to the department to pay it, that's why you paid it indirectly. And that's what the feature of indirect tax. Indirect tax we don't pay directly, we pay it indirectly, and that's why it is less pinching. It doesn't hurt you. Okay, tomorrow when you will be earning in crores, we had discussed and computed income tax. You know, if you are earning in 1 crore, approximately 30% you will pay as a tax. So 35 lakh you will pay as a tax in India. When you pay the 35 lakh tax to the government, that will hurt you for sure. You earn one crore rupees, out of 1 crore rupees you are paying 35 lakh. That will pakka hurt you, but indirect tax is not hurting you, because you had purchased mobile, you have purchased clothes, you have purchased lot of things from your childhood, and every time you do some spending, you have paid taxes as well. Okay? Yeah? And that's why indirect taxes be paid indirectly. So that is direct and indirect tax. Sir, so why the hell we are paying taxes? This is the answer. Taxes are levied and collected. Why? To fund what? Cost of civilization. You want better civilization every day? You want better infrastructure, better government, better defense, better law and order? That is civilized society. We are civilized, isn't it? We are not staying in forest. If you don't want to pay taxes, you are welcome. You can go to Himalayas, you can go to forest. Stay in forest, no taxes, no regulation, no law. Alright? No sir, we want road, we want healthcare, we want hospitals, we want education. Okay, if you want all these things, you have to pay taxes. This is the logic behind why do we pay taxes. I'm taking you to the ground, right, root of taxations. Alright, now this is economic, this is none of my business. You have to go and study this particular concept from your economics faculty, or it might already delivered. I don't know, is it delivered canon of taxation? There is national level chapter, national income chapter, national income and national expenditure, GDP and all. Alright, one of that particular component is taxes. Okay, because it is a revenue to the government. Alright, now government, while making particular law in the nation, they should keep these fundamental principles in life, okay, in mind. So your overall law should be within this bracket. This is the overall bracket that we put, and this is not put by any Indian government, or this is not any law and regulation. It is just a framework that you have to follow. You know, if you are the lawmaker, if you are writing GST for me, so government will come and they will tell you all these things. See, it has to follow canon of equity, it has to follow canon of certainty, it has to follow canon of economy, it has to follow canon of elasticity, it has to follow canon of productivity. This is what I will tell you. By keeping this in mind, you drop my provisions, isn't it? So this is the guideline principles. We call it canon of taxation. What is the canon? Canon of canon means principles. Okay, rules. Canon of taxation means an appropriate set of principle. Who introduced this concept? So father of economics. Who is the father of economics? Originally introduced by Adam Smith. You know what is once particular thing is written in economics by one particular economist, what other economists will do? They will criticize it. So many people had criticized it and many people had contributed to more canons. So originally he had introduced only 3 canons, but I had written 5, 6. You can go and write, there are 7, almost 9 canons we have. All I am not writing, you Google out about this also. What is canon of equity? People misunderstand this particular word. Canon of equity means everybody should pay same amount of taxes. This is what they feel, equity. It's not like that. Everybody need not to pay same amount of tax. Everybody should pay taxes according to their level of income. Okay, so if you are earning low income, you should pay low tax. If you are earning average income, you should pay average tax. If you are earning higher income, you should pay higher tax. If you are earning highest income, you should pay highest tax. Am I clear? Canon of equity means you need to follow progressive system of taxation. Progressive, which is followed by direct tax, isn't it? More you earn, more you pay. Yeah, your taxes will increase in direct proportion of your increase in income. Okay, this is how it operates. Canon of certainty, every day I am changing GST rate. Will it be okay? Every month I am changing GST form. Every month I am changing income tax rates. Certainty, that means people, now you are certain how much tax you will pay in next year? Yes, because they had given us a budget that next year these are the tax rate that you know. Hello, up to 2.5 lakh nil, 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh, 5%. Everybody knows this. This is what certainty. Suddenly, if government comes tomorrow and say, "Bhai or bhaino, like now tax rate is 50%. Hello? That will hurt you, that will hurt me. And that's why, while making law, they are making it very sure that for next year, we will announce budget in Feb, we will have debate in month of Feb, and we will approve that budget before 1st April, because everybody should know in advance that from April to March, how much amount of taxes they are expected to pay. Okay, yeah, that is canon of certainty. Canon of economy, do you see income tax building everywhere? Every station has one income tax building. Jogeshwari one building, Dadar one building, Andheri one building, your native also have one building. Do you see income tax officers everywhere? No, very rarely we see. We don't even see income tax van. You understand, there also have their cars and all income tax. In Churchgate you can see, because there are a lot of income tax buildings. But here we don't have. Why, sir? Why we don't have this particular income tax offices everywhere? Because government follow canon of economy. Canon of economy means cost of collection of taxes should not be higher than taxes itself. Hello. If government is appointing thousands commissioner, thousand officers to collect taxes from thousand people, that doesn't make any sense. I am paying 1000 crore to collect 1200 taxes. That means margin available only. Instead of that, let them not to pay taxes, because there is no point. I'm just like collecting taxes and paying their salary, collecting taxes and paying the rent, collecting taxes and paying the electricity bill of income tax department. My cost of collection has to be minimal, then only government can have a better margin. And that's why government is not hiring more people in income tax department. And right now, Modi government is focused on e-governance, alright? Everything will be handled electronically, and if things are handled electronically, your industry will shift from labor intensive to capital intensive. One person can handle, because one computer can handle 1000 assessments at the same time. So instead of 1000 officers, just we need one or two officers who will follow that particular computer. Okay, and computers are more efficient than human, although it is invented by humans, but they are like more efficient, more powerful than human brain. Okay, yeah, and that's what they are trying to do. Everything they are putting in e-governance. That is canon of economy. Canon of elasticity, if you the best example I can give about elasticity is that this sanitary napkin that you people use, girls usually use, all right and that there was a movie, I guess Akshay Kumar movie, Padman, I guess, yeah. And through that movie and many other, even NGOs and all, they had protested against it, that there was a GST on sanitary napkins and it has to be removed. In last meeting itself, like 1 month back, they had taken the meeting and they had removed GST from sanitary napkins, and everybody welcomed this. Whole industry has welcomed this particular thing, because they had done very good thing. That means sometime law has to be changed as per the needs of the industry, as per the needs of the economy, as per the needs of the people. Because every time you cannot put a tax on everything, sometime you need to change the law. On cigarette and tobacco, they are having high rate of tax. Why? Because they don't want that people should consume it. And if people are ready to consume it, then you pay. You should be ready to pay taxes as well. So non-AC restaurants are not under GST, but AC restaurants are under. GST. 5-star restaurant are under 18% GST, normal restaurant are 5% GST. Now you choose whether you are supposed to go to normal restaurant or 5-star restaurant. If you are going to 5-star restaurant, then pay 18%. Hello? Yeah? If you take a normal open ingredient from Kirana shop, no GST. If you go to Big Bazaar, you wanted to buy sophisticated, in a sophisticated market, then you have to pay taxes. You understand? So that depends on you. So canon of elasticity means as and when required, law has to be changed, and that's why law is dynamic. That's why law is dynamic. Okay? Canon of productivity is again same as per the requirement of the nation. Taxes should not hurt our economy, and that's why government always give basic exemption limit to all industry. Our industry should not be under pressure of taxation. Taxation should not kill productivity of the nation. It has to enhance the productivity of the nation. So there are a lot of benefit given to SME sector, small and medium enterprise sector. So that sector gets lot of benefit in form of taxation, tax incentives. So likewise, we are having lot of canons. You need to read it, because these are the logics why law operates like that. These are not, I'm teaching you for your exam perspective. These are just the logic. Why income tax is progressive, somebody asks. Everybody know income tax is progressive. If somebody asks, why is it progressive, sir? Hello, why is it progressive? Because there is a canon of equity. Rich people has to pay more tax. Poor people should not pay tax. And what government is trying to do, how government is trying to balance this particular. Now, indirect tax is a regressive system. That means if you go and buy Parle G, if I go and buy Parle G, although our level of income is different, but we will pay same amount of tax. But you know what? You will buy Parle G, I will buy Oreo. Because the moment there is an increase in my income, there will be increase in my spending habits. You will buy Tata Nano, I will buy Mercedes. Hello, somebody else will buy, higher version of something. Somebody will buy aeroplane, private jet. So if you are having more money, that means you will spend more money. Now Ambanis are spending crores of rupees. Hello, they are paying crores of rupees of taxes. Their children are studying in government school. They are getting admitted in government hospital. They are using government transport system, government buses. No, that means people who are paying highest amount of taxes are taking lowest benefit from government, and people are not paying higher amount, or like the people are paying only negligible amount of taxes, they are benefited like anything. Isn't it? You lower class people, they get, according to food chain system, they get food at 2 rupee kg, 1 rupee kg. Ration system, ration card system. Who is, like, food manufacturing cost is too much. Transportation cost is higher than manufacturing of that particular food article. But we are making it available to the lower section of the economy. Why? Because they don't afford it. You understand? Somebody is paying for it. Who is paying for it? Government. Sir, government to pay government should have this particular money in their hand. To pay this money, government will collect it from richer section of the society. So what government trying to do? Government is trying to take taxes from richer section, and they are trying to give benefit to lower section of the economy. Benefits are available to anyone. It's not that benefits are available to only lower section. Tomorrow, if Ambani decide to put his son into government school will not stop it. Is open to all. The condition is that they don't take this particular benefit. Okay? Even they can travel by railway class. Even they can travel by our BST bus. But they don't travel. They travel in their own cars. But they have option to travel. Everybody can use government facilities. Okay? Government facilities on for all. But reality that lower section is not paying taxes. Middle section is paying average amount of taxes. And rich section is paying highest amount of taxes. And they are taking lowest benefit from government. Okay, so all those logics are written in canons. This is just logic, not forming this is not a part of tax. Okay, this is a part of economics. Additional discussion you do with your economics faculty. All right, chalo, next.